Good evening. Our opening hymn is number 820 in your missalette. All for all the saints, verses 1, 4, and 7.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening.
Good
evening. Certainly welcome as we gather. We gather on this eve, celebrating the solemnity of all saints, recognizing that they are with God, singing eternal praises and glory to God. We seek to experience a bit of God's inspiration and grace as we gather here for Mass today. We prepare by calling to mind our sin. We ask God for forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people.
Heavenly King, O God Almighty.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you, for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels, who were given power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on our foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne, and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen. Blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed the robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Ascend the mountain of the Lord.
or who may stand in his holy place. One whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain. Receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Everyone who has this hope based on him makes himself pure as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
With
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Today we gather with the church throughout the world to celebrate the great solemnity of All Saints' Day. This day celebrates all the saints, those who have been officially recognized and canonized as saints in the church, and especially it's a time for us to celebrate with all the saints, even those who do not have an exact day of remembrance, who are already enjoying the blessing of being with God in heaven. The readings today drew my focus to two important aspects of this celebration. First, in the reading from Revelation, we hear about the large multitude, people gathered from every tribe and nation, standing before the throne, offering their endless praise and honor to God. This makes me think about gatherings that we experience. Maybe you think about summer, gathering of family or others for some special event. Maybe you think about the gathering for a wedding or other type of things where people sort of congregate or gather together. I have to admit that I got into watching some of the baseball over the last few weeks or month. You know, Cleveland, oh, I almost said Indians, the Guardians, you know, as they battle the New York Yankees and now the World Series, and as it's over. You know, but it always is amazing to see these stadiums filled with people. Of course, that's multiplied for football games and on and on and on. But just all these people that are gathered, somehow hoping to share in the joy of their team's victory. You know, that they do all these kind of things of trying to wear certain clothes or chants or whatever, somehow being a part of this. And also then it strikes me that often at different times on TV, they'll give scenes from other stadiums or people gathered in the streets. You know, it looks like thousands of people who gather somehow, once again, to offer their support and somehow being connected with hopefully the success of their favorite team. So when we think about that, you know, the description that we heard in the reading from the book of Revelation, That also helps us to kind of think about the saints. You know, as we heard that line from Revelation about all this vast crowd, the 144,000, and then this great crowd that nobody could count, that somehow they're gathered there, and that's still from their place in heaven. They have some interest and concern for us. That I think it was Matthew Kelly, where he talked about the saints as like our greatest cheerleaders, those who are there cheering us on and giving us inspiration and hope, that as they are experiencing that fullness of life and joy and love and things that we can't even imagine, that as they're experiencing that already with God in heaven, somehow they're desiring that for us and cheering us on, helping us in those struggles to hopefully become victorious when we are called from our life here. The second aspect of the readings that jumped out for me is in the gospel reading, Matthew's edition of Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. In these Beatitudes, Jesus presents a way of living that will assure us of knowing the blessing of living with God. As one commentator said, these Beatitudes are not for the faint of heart. The very first one begins by saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit." So this states that we need to begin with a profound recognition that we live in some state of poverty. We cannot provide all that we need. Ultimately, we cannot provide for our own salvation. We need Jesus. This can be very challenging in the world in which we live. So much of our culture upholds our own ability to determine what we think is right. Our culture tells us that we can gain happiness by wielding worldly power and accumulating many worldly treasures. While we do need to be diligent in using the gifts that God has given us to attend to our earthly needs and responsibilities, in the end, we hear that over and over, that these things of the world cannot bring us complete fulfillment and happiness. They cannot bring us salvation. Only faith in God can provide that. Spend some time praying with the Beatitudes. Does one of them jump out for you? Perhaps that is what Jesus upholds for you in order to be able to progress on that path to blessings that are offered as part of his kingdom. Also, as we look to the example of the saints, they really are our friends. They are united with us in powerful spiritual ways, encouraging us and inspiring us on the path to become saints. I saw a brief summary of ideas on how to grow in holiness offered by three different saints from different time periods in the history of the church. All of them have the name Teresa. Their statements to me express ideas of how, as we maybe struggle with the enticements or realities of the world around us, how they can, how these simple things can help us to keep our eyes focused on the Lord and progress in his ways. First was that of St. Teresa of Avila. She was known as a great mystic, one of deep prayer, that she said simply, "Recharge your spiritual batteries every day by prayer," namely, listening to God and talking to him. So that reminder of that importance of regular prayer, of raising our minds and our hearts to God. St. Teresa of Lisieux, the little flower, the one who seems so humble and little, and it's like, what can I possibly do? That she said, convert every action into prayer by offering it to God for his glory and for the salvation of souls, and by doing God's will to the best of one's ability. That's all we can do. You know, we can't do it to, you know, some other great saint's ability, you know, or somebody that we've honored all of our life for their great holiness. Certainly we're inspired and strive for that, but all just to the best of our ability that we try to offer what we have as a prayer to God. And finally, that of St. Teresa of Calcutta, Mother Teresa. She simply said, do ordinary things with great love. So on this day, as we celebrate with all the saints, we pray that God will give us the grace to follow the path revealed by Jesus in the Beatitudes so that we will be a blessing to those around us and one day experience the incredible joy of being united with all the saints and offering that eternal praise to God. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life for the world to come. Amen. Lord Jesus, poor in spirit, we recognize our need for your grace and inspiration in our lives. Seeking your divine blessing, we come to you with our needs and our prayers.
For Pope Francis, Bishop Thomas, and all church leaders, may they inspire us to embrace our call to be faithful members of God's family, spreading the good news in word and deed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, as we approach Election Day, may all citizens exercise their right to vote, and may God grant us wisdom to elect candidates who will promote justice and peace for all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, may we always acknowledge our need for God in our life, and may we look to the saints for inspiration, finding in them examples of holiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who mourn the loss of a loved one, may they find strength, comfort, and consolation in Christ's promise of eternal life to those who honor Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in the number of young men to serve as priests in our local church, may God provide shepherds to bring the Eucharist to our parish communities and empower all to be generous in their vocation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from illness, disease, or other trials of life, may they remain strong in faith and trust in the promise of blessing that comes from God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the living and deceased members of the Paul and Dolores Cape family, may all the faithful departed be united with Jesus and all the saints in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers written in the Parish Book of Intentions in our personal prayers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of all holiness, your Son came to live among us as one poor in spirit and gentle of heart, thus showing us the blessings of your kingdom. We ask that you hear our prayers and answer them through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join in our offertory hymn, number 744. Come to me, number 744.
Come to me, all who labor and are heavy burdened, and I shall give you rest. Take up my yoke and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you to me, all who labor and are heavy burdened.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that, just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the church through whom you give us in our frailty both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with a multitude of saints and angels as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 574, Take Our Bread, number 574.
Take our bread, we ask you, take our hearts, we love you, take our lives, oh Father, we are yours, we are yours. stand at the table you set. Yours as we eat the bread of hearts can't forget. We are the signs of our life with us yet. We are yours. We are yours. So take our bread. We ask you, take our hearts. We love you, take our lives. Oh, Father, we are yours. We are yours. Your holy people standing washed in your blood. Spirit-filled yet hungry, we await your food. We are poor, but we brought ourselves the best we could. We are yours. We are yours. Take our bread. Take our lives. We love you. Take our lives. Oh, Father, we are yours. We are yours.
Thank you.
Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly homeland. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a reminder that tomorrow on the 1st, there are the whole series of masses beginning 6:30 a.m. at Blakesley, 8:45 here for the school. And I know I was around a little bit today, and the kids are already excited. They get to dress up as their favorite saint. So what will appear? I'm anxious to see that. Truly a blessing. And then at noon and 7 in the evening at St. Michael in Hicksville. So if there are people out there, you can pass that schedule on to them. Also remember that then as we enter into November, the Saturday 4 o'clock Mass will be at St. Michael in Hicksville. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do that, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power, thrust into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our closing song is number 818, For All the Saints Who've Shown Your Love, number 818.